Yo, yo, what's up, Mzansi? It's so Monday, it's the Boys Lounge, and we're all about that hashtag Monday Motivation. Welcome to it. You tune into the best thing on your mama's television. This is XA Right Show on Cape Town TV, taking you all the way up until 5 p.m. Kamlam Snaloga Chunasi, Mara Wena, you can call me Butfliki. I am giving you the honors. I am
the permission. The permission. Diakuva, Butfliki, Diakuva, we hear you. My name is the Sheriff Forbes, and you know, it is a blue Monday. We all are feeling it, even I'm feeling it. You can tell by my voice. But we're going to kick that Monday blues away. Listen, today's show is nothing short but educational, entertainment, everything. And it is proudly sponsored by Learning Trust, Ashley. Connect with us on our social media on Facebook, XC on Cape Town TV, and on Twitter at XC underscore live.
Definitely do what you gotta do to make sure you are part of the show. It's Blue Monday. Even my fringe is on Blue Monday. Mara, it's okay. It's okay. We're gonna give you a show that will leave you inspired. Speaking of inspiration, later on the show we'll be joined by Emagqabini Education Academy. They're all about uplifting underprivileged communities through education and of course future planning. So later on we'll be joined by a founder and of course a tutor of Emagqabini.
Absolutely. Not only that, we're also checking out a cool local short film that was actually shot in Mzansi. We love everything Mzansi does, everything Mzansi do and creates. That is what we love. Also, we'll be checking out some cool, interesting hobbies that you can do for your June holidays, just in case you actually ran out, because Lama actually went to Somerset West. So stick around for that.
Yeah, stick around for that. Do what you gotta do. Mara, now it's time for skinnering.
For Stanze.
We're
gonna check out trending news. What's the ha? A state for skinner, or what we call it, trending news. Now this is actually the part of the show where we actually take a look at celebville and what actually happened on our timeline. Sinalo, tell us.
Yo, first things first, man, some good news for Sibiya actually who went on social media to say that she has finally paid off Ifizake the university. Well, Sibiya is famous for the song of Umama Kabafana, and of course for playing and role on lockdown. Nontombike has officially paid Ifizake University. So we're saying well done, Mukhal.
Absolutely, absolutely. Another thing that's very interesting, actually, is we love our rappers. Our rappers in
Mzansi,
they are lit. There's always something to talk about. One rapper in particular, I'm talking about MT. Now, one of his Twitter followers actually wrote on his timeline after people witnessed that MT actually fell down during his performance this past weekend in Durban. Now, while Twitter was on fire after this incident with the negative comments, real hip-hop fans were actually sympathizing with the rapper, and they didn't actually find the video funny at all. But this guy was like,
he pulled the Wendy Williams on stage, man. He pulled the Wendy Williams there. Well, on the other side, Jackie Pamoto, who's famous for Ubala Incwadi Yakhe, that is called Bear, has been, of course, recognized for a contribution to African literature by the African Icon Awards in Nigeria. She has been selected as one of the seven individuals who will be receiving this award, and this award is decided by the board of the African Icon Awards in Nigeria. So she's receiving it, and the book tells it all, darling. Have you read the book?
I haven't read the book yet, but I'm definitely
You need to
interested.
Read the book. It tells you all about the underworld.
Everything, darling.
But on the other side, the Carter family, the clan.
Hey, they are coming.
Mzansi, the whole entire clan. Jay-Z, Beyonce, Blue Ivy, the twins. Ooh, we need protection, guys.
We need it. I'm not going to say the
word.
We're going to be sacrificing. Hey. Let's take a breather. We need to, you know, breathe and take everything in. We'll see you now. Hey, it's still the Sheriff and Bootlick himself. You're tuned into XAIR. Comment on our social media pages if there's anything that you want to leave. You know, we love your comments and things like that. But we're taking you all the way till 5 p.m.
Definitely do what you got to do to make sure you're part of the show. Love how you say Bootlick, man. That sounds, we feel very good. Man, joining us right now on the lookout is, of course, also Cindy Sibolo, who's the founder of Emagqabini Education Academy, alongside with Oabongile, who's the tutor of this amazing academy. The work that they do with the young kids is amazing. They founded this academy 4 years ago. Mara, I'm gonna say 5 years ago, because it was founded in 2014. Guys, welcome on the show and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having us.
So Cindy, you are doing an amazing job, and I just want to say the amazing job that you do with the young kids of Ekhayelitsha is amazing. And thank you so much for making sure that you uplift our communities. Mm-hmm. So let's talk about the idea behind Emagqabini. What triggered the idea for you to start the academy?
Thank you. So the reason I started Emagqabini is actually because I couldn't find an organization closer to my house, SIB, okay. When my sister was struggling with her own subjects.
Yeah.
So then what I decided to start a homework support group for her and her friends.
Yeah.
So when we started out, we had like 15 kids, and it was her and her friends and some people abahlala estradweni sethu. And yeah, and then once we moved to the library, more kids became interested.
Yeah.
And that's how then we opened up to like the entire community.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So like now we're working in two areas, site B and site C. And we have about over 100 kids that we're supporting this
year. Wow.
But that's your main aim as well too. It basically focuses on uplifting, you know, under-resourced communities through education and future planning, etc. So how is it that you guys actually then do? What is it that you do to make sure that you then kind of uplift these communities through the future planning and things like this?
So what we do, we help them with tutoring, focusing on maths and physics and English.
Okay.
And we also place them in extramural activities. Mm-hmm. For example, we've got about 20 learners that are part of the yacht club this year.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Yeah. Yeah. And actually, just to brag, two of them went to Spain this
year. Hey, now.
Wow. Spain.
What's up?
Wow.
Yes.
That is amazing.
And we also assist them with career planning. Yeah. So if you're in matric, we partner you with a mentor.
Yes.
And then it's someone you can talk to about which subjects do you need to choose and how do you apply and all those kind of things of having to think about the next level.
Yeah. And it's things that you need, especially in matric, things that you need that sometimes it's lacking, you know, just that guidance in
and encouragement as well. Amazing. You know what, I'm going back to high school because I also want to go to Spain and join Emagqabini. So Abosh, thank you so much also for joining us. Let's talk about you, a tutor of Emagqabini. You focus on EMET. Let's talk about how do you encourage the learners, the kids you work with, to actually make sure what they stay in line and they stay focused.
Thanks for hosting us, guys. Basically, it comes with me.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because when I was studying in high school, so then again, I am doing this for my kwazu ukwenza home exam.
Yeah.
So umama wam then sitting once in the homework, and then I tatakayazi na. So I have to work very hard for it. And we have to do a study group. And then sisebenzima. So sasebenza sisebenza ebusuku kude kube sekuseni oko sisenza into esisifunda yabo. So then I was like, okay, if this is happening to me that time, then now at least in the same university and I can be able to help abanye abantwana, which is they are facing the same problem which I was facing that time. So yeah, it started with me. So to uplift now abantu bafundisayo ngoku. What I do, I always tell them the stories, and I always relate whatever that I've been there, I've done that. So nani nizokwazi
ukudlulela. I like the fact that he says it begins with me.
Yeah,
that is
exactly
a very good thing.
And you know, most of the times we hear, there is support in mathematics and science and things like that, but sometimes this is always the same thing, you know, the way the tutoring process is going and things like that. I want to know from you guys, what is it that you guys do different in terms of giving that mathematical and science support? What is it, what do you guys then do different?
What we do different, I can say, we always make maths fun.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because, you know, there are stories that they say maths is difficult.
Yeah.
But you always make it a play because, you know, learners, most especially those are starting high school, like grade 8, they always like to play, but you make it fun, like play games, but using maths.
Exactly.
Yeah. Wow,
so
that
we
is
make
amazing.
It exciting.
Exactly. And that's how they actually become more interested.
Yeah,
exactly.
And it's very good to use imagination in class to make sure we'll see the kids or the learners actually remember the mathematics.
Exactly.
What you call it. I don't know what you call it. But since I'm in South Africa, there are actually few kids learners who actually take maths in high school because we believe it's very, very difficult. Mm. Tell me, how does the process of selecting the learners and the kids you work with, how do you choose?
So on that note, what we do, we don't actually even look at your results.
Wow. Okay?
Yeah, well, and also we don't, you know, if kids say, okay, maths, I'll rather go for maths lit, we encourage them that.
Yeah.
Because what's important for us is that they feel comfortable and that they feel confident.
Yes.
To be able to do, you know, because sometimes they'll be like, oh, pure maths, it's difficult, yeah, and whatever,
exactly,
or whatever. So if they feel first like they want to start with this one, then it's fine.
Yes.
Because as long as they believe,
yeah,
they can do
that,
it,
yeah,
yes,
they'll be able,
yes,
to do it.
Yes. And I'm sure the community is obviously overwhelmed by this initiative that you guys are actually doing. But I want to know, I know obviously a lot of kids are interested because, I mean, the support is there, the help is there. But as the parents, are they very helpful? Do they interact with you guys as well? How's the support?
No, they do interact with us.
Okay.
I mean, when we have quarterly meetings,
mm-hmm,
so they attend the meetings.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But some of them don't. they'll WhatsApp.
They WhatsApp. They got WhatsApp group. Parents WhatsApp group.
WhatsApp, yeah. Yeah. WhatsApp, they're very good.
Yeah,
and
okay,
when you call them,
yeah,
then they'll give you feedback.
Yeah.
But, oh, you guys are so helpful,
yeah,
and that kind of thing.
So they are actively,
yeah,
involved.
Yeah,
they are
involved.
Yeah.
That,
yeah,
sounds amazing.
It
it's
is
good to make sure that the parents are actually involved in the activity.
Definitely.
Like, whether it's pure maths or it's math lead, they are both maths guys at the end of the day.
Exactly.
Well, this one, final words, if someone would love to join, would love to contact you guys, where do they go about doing that?
So they can check out our website, www.emagqabinieedu.org.
Mm-hmm.
They can also catch us on Facebook,
yeah,
Emagqabini Education Academy. We actually, that's up to date, so we're always interacting there.
Well, there you have it, Cindy and Abungile, all the way from Emagqabini. Thank you so much, guys. Keep on doing what you do. We definitely appreciate you guys. Well, there you have it, guys. Right now, we're going to check out 45 seconds of Emagqabini.
Yes.
We'll be right back straight after this.
Do you remember the first person or teacher to believe in you? I do. For me, it was Mr. Singley, my maths teacher. When he saw that I was struggling with maths, he introduced me to an academic support program. For many young South Africans, academic support is not accessible. At the Future Igniters, we would like to be that first memorable teacher. We need your help to make this possible. We need 250,000 rand to launch the hub and create access to resources and support for young township youth. Donate today. No donation is too small. Let's ignite the future together.
Welcome back, Sabule XAY Show on Cape Town TV. All about that hashtag Give Monday, all about the hashtag Monday Motivation. And right about now, we're joined by a student, actually, who's tutored by Emagqabini Education Academy. And apparently, he's very good when it comes to maths.
Hey.
Brother, welcome on the show.
Mucho, mucho.
Hey, yes, represent, represent. So you're part of the organization, the initiative,
the
Academy.
Yes.
What has it been like for you, man? How has it actually helped you become better in maths and all of your other subjects?
In 2016,
uh-huh,
I started in high school and then in Tuscan Glen High.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I was struggling in maths.
Uh-huh.
In us, code 3 was the highest mark.
Seriously?
Wow.
Okay.
And then in 2017, my parents advised me to go to Emagqabini Education,
mm-hmm,
Academy. And then since then, my grades are higher than last. Yeah, you see.
So they're improving all the time.
They're improving all the time.
Yeah.
Because in Emagqabini, they tell us that dream big, work hard, and stay motivated.
Yeah.
They tell us that, you see, if you want to be the best, you must hard work the best.
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
hard work beat talent, hard work beat skills.
Exactly.
Wow, amazing. That is good. I like the fact that you say hard work beats talent, it beats skills.
Exactly.
I'll keep that in mind.
So,
Emagqabini is not an easy subject. Why, when it is Uma Sunwabe, you decided to go to Emagqabini and Zawienza throughout high school?
Yeah.
Emagqabini, I can't see, man. Because
yeah,
because they say that you must practice every time.
Yeah.
Tina's practice, every subject is hard about practice.
Yeah.
If you practice every day and every day, because by Emagqabini, this is a unique guide.
Yes.
By in medicine, it's practical. Because you call the practical, like,
yeah,
mm-hmm.
Amazing.
So you say that you've been part of the program, your parents actually told you, look, this is, you need to go to the academy, see if it's going to help and things like that. Obviously, you told us that the improvements are there and things like that. Now, for the kids at home and they're thinking, I wonder if I should actually apply or become a part of the academy. What would you say to them? Why should they become part of the academy?
They should, because Emagqabini is just not focused mm-hmm. on academical things only,
mm-hmm.
because they are business things.
Yeah.
And your clubs.
Mm-hmm.
You see, even last week we went to what you were talking about. The Deponest pizza owners.
Hey,
yeah.
You see, there are a lot of things in Emagqabini.
Yeah,
yeah, there are a lot of things.
So it's more than just education then. It's about having fun.
Yes.
Yeah, it's all about young people having fun, and they use maths to have fun. Which is a very good thing. Now we're part of Emagqabini. How are you dealing with Emagqabini? Are you going to serve and give back to your community? How are you planning on doing that?
Yes, definitely. No, I'm just by tutor in Emagqabini. Experience because you know that kawena ufundisa usho into ingene nakuwe more than kawu igcina pha kuinto.
Yes, amazing.
Definitely. Now, if I were to guess your ultimate goal, I would say you want to become a mathematician, but I'm sure
there's more to it. Yeah.
So if I were to ask you what's your ultimate goal that you love to achieve, what would it be?
I want to be successful, mm-hmm. not rich.
Yeah,
that's very interesting.
That's very interesting.
Because there is a difference between being successful and rich.
And I want to be in PR or a lecturer for economics.
Wow, okay. That is great. So tell us about the subjects you do in high school, and what is one thing that you're most grateful for being part of Emagqabini?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I do tourism, business study, economics, and English and Afrikaans and ELO.
Oh,
you brought it. I brought it.
Yeah.
And mostly Italian. And what I know I'm grateful of is that Emagqabini is not just an organization.
Yeah.
It's there to uplift everyone.
Likhaya Emagqabini. You can say it's a home.
It's your second home.
Yeah,
basically.
It's a home away from home.
Because we live in Kailicha.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Home.
Now, very important question that I want to ask you, and just try to hold your mic as well, because I want people to take note of your answer, right? We all go through high school, we all go through secondary education and things like that.
Luckily, I jumped high school.
Hey, this guy!
Went straight to varsity.
A very important question. Do you think that high school prepares you enough for tertiary education, for university and things like that? Do you think that it kind of puts you in the right state of mind? Yes or no?
Yes.
And why would you say that?
Because in grade 7,
uh-huh.
they teach you the basics.
Okay.
From grade 8 to 9,
mm-hmm.
they now show you if you want to do like natural science,
mm-hmm.
but
yeah.
was bit in, or mm-hmm. if you want to do EMS.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And now in grade 10, it's up to you.
Exactly.
From the grade 1 since grade 9 experience, if you which one do you think that you are based in?
Yes.
Definitely, as Mnane, kubaluleke kanjani for abantwana base high school to actually be part of after school programs. How important is it?
It's very important because uyazi xa ubhizi uye liba nezinye izinto ezinegative.
Yeah.
Because ekhaya ugcwele yaziwa ngeento ezimbi. Ke ngoku xa after school program, which often it was needs benefit, or learn many things about
because we know that we are in public schools, and then there are less things
about but after school bike bonding like
and tell me about the extra and co-curricular activities. This is now beside the numbers and things like that you guys actually do at the academy, and what is it that you actually enjoy the most? You did mention the yacht club. But I mean, is that your favorite, or is there anything else?
No, mine is entrepreneurship.
Okay.
That one is about business.
Okay.
We are doing it now since the whole day started until when the whole day ended.
Okay.
You see?
Wow.
We learn about how to start a business and what which obstacles that business owners have.
Yes.
Yeah. You see?
So this guy's just
this guy is doing everything.
Bill Gates, I'm telling you.
He's the next Bill Gates.
I don't have time for no yachts or things like that. I'm business,
yeah. Well, Mugai, thank you so much. Nesabula was joining us and keep on doing what you're doing. We want an A from you at the end of the year, right?
Yes.
Definitely. Well, that is of course that is of course the student of Emagqabini. But right now we're Emagqabini Asemagqabini. We're gonna take a quick breather and we'll be right back.
Yes, and wait for us the whole day, please.
Well, like I say, is the name of the show. We're still taking you all the way up until 5 p.m. Well, okay, guys, every week we give organizations around Mzansi the opportunity to tell us and show us the amazing work that they do to uplift Abantu Abatsha base South Africa. So now, if you know any organization around South Africa that is doing amazing work to uplift the community Zabo, to make sure you give us a call at 021-448-0448, or you can send us an email at xa@capetowntv.org. So do what you got to do to make sure your organization is actually exposed to the rest of Mzansi. But right now, we're going to check out a very cool short film that is created by first year after students. It's called Obsessions. So let's check it out. We'll be back with more.
Coffee. I haven't seen you in so long. I've really missed you.
Don't worry, I won't be leaving anytime soon.
Well, the name of the show is called XA, and it's a Monday. We're all about that hashtag Monday Motivation, where we inspire you and motivate you and educate you. So without wasting any further ado, let's take a look at some education fillers.
Absolutely. Educational fillers, I told you, it's all about edutainment. The first thing that I have for you is the Equal Education, better known as the EE, had its National Congress last week, actually. Now, the Congress was held at the Wits University Education Campus in Park Town, where 19 members were actually selected to serve on the National Council to its highest decision making. Now, the organization has been doing great things for young people in schools. So good luck to the new team, and we wish you all the best.
Yes, amazing. Well, on the other side, guys, be aware of fake websites.
Please.
Because They can do things on your phone. Welcome, members of the public have been, of course, urged to be vigilant and report fake websites to the police as the mispresentation of qualifications poses a threat to the country's education system. This was a statement issued by Umalusi after they found out that people open fake websites to sell fake matric certificates to the public. Yeah. So you guys at home should be aware of that. I am a victim of entering a fake website and then my phone was scammed every
day.
Oh
my word. I also enter a few fake websites, but that's a story for another
for
day.
For another day.
And I'm saying, moving along swiftly, we all remember in 2016 when young people took to the streets to strike for fees must fall. Now, for others, it has been forgotten, but for some, they are still paying for all these damages that were actually done by the students. Now, 7 students who were actually charged over the hashtag Fees Must Fall protest in Cape Town will be diverted from the court system to a complete community service at school. So it might have happened two years ago, but they are still feeling the brunt of this. We wish them all the best actually with that as well.
Definitely. Well, that is of course Education Feelers right here on XA. If there's anything that we've missed, to make sure you connect with us on our social media platforms, XA_live on Twitter and of course XA on Facebook.
Absolutely.
Man, I know it's time for us to dance. Can I put this here?
You know, we want to take a musical interview.
Yes.
Check this out, man.
Yes.
You know, I just want to.
Yes.
Hey, welcome back. I know you guys are thinking, hey, is this hobbies or what happening here? Well, we had a bit of technical difficulties there, getting, you know, the signal for that inserts and things like that to play. But one more time, just in case you just walked in again and you just missed what we are going to check out. We're going to check out a few interesting hobbies for your June holidays, because if you are like me and you ran out of hobbies and you don't know what to do anymore with yourself, you're just laying there. Here's an insert, actually, that Lama actually went to Somerset with to check out some cool, interesting hobbies that you can actually do for your June holidays before it actually ends as well. This time it's the insert.
Hi, my name is Gian. I play tennis for the 6 years old. Ek ken dit, my ouma het my net gekry en ons het baie tens gekyk op TV, dis hoe ek van die sport begin hou het. En hierdie rede kom ek nou nog deesdae tennis speel, is omdat dit my nader aan my broer en my familie bring. Ons kon speel gereeld, maar net om ons 'n bietjie fiks te hou, want ons is maar 'n bietjie lui, sit op die bank gereeld. Maar ja, ek stem saam, tennis is 'n baie lekker sport, jy hardloop baie, sweet baie, op warm dae kou daar ook. So ja, tennis is vir almal.
Some hobbies are inherited, just like him. He grew up watching tennis on TV and his parents were playing tennis. So he was, let's say, usulelwe ngabazali bakhe, bamenze bamakathanda i-tennis. And every Saturday morning, uyadlala netshomi zakhe i-tennis, and this is his hobby. I'm gonna try my luck and see if I can hit the bat, or the ball, or both of them. Let's see Lama in action.
Welcome back to the XAY show on Cape Town TV, the best thing on your mama's television. Ubugupi, the whole entire hour we were here entertaining everyone in Mzansi. Mara, no, we've got one more thing to do for you, which is something that you need to know.
Exactly. This is called need to know, something that you definitely need to know, something that we are actually proud to announce to you as well. So here we go. First one first is the AFDA was proud to announce that they actually selected three AFDA 2017 graduate films for their 45th Student Academy Awards. Now, what you need to know about that is that you'll be able to achieve great things and you'll still be able to do what you love by being a filmmaker. Thank you, AFDA.
Amazing. AFDA is doing great things out there. While on the other side, another company that is doing amazing thing is Fly SA Fair has signed on a platinum sponsor for the Girl Fly program in Africa Foundation's 2018 Aviation and Space Camp, which introduces more than 120 high school girls into from the Southern African Development Community region into the aviation industry. This is how this is to show that you can be anything that you want to be in life. So yes, girls can be anything they want to be in life. That's how we say
most definitely, most definitely, 100%. Listen, I know today's show was nothing short of educational, and I hope that you actually took note of today's show and actually saw that there's much more things to do than just sitting at home and actually just chilling and doing nothing. We showed you hobbies, we showed you maths, we showed you everything today, and I hope you enjoy the show as
definitely
well.
And of course a big shout out to our guests for coming in, Usindi Abosh, all the way from Emagqabini Foundation, and also that guy who showed us his hobby. He did an amazing job. He did an amazing job. If you want to catch more action from us, to make sure you catch the repeat tomorrow between 7 to 8 in the morning, and also so you can catch the whole entire live show. Jennifer and I will beg to entertain you again. Social media, Sikona, everywhere.
Everywhere.
But now I'm dry here. Yeah, I need to drink some water. I've been doing talking.
Yeah, speaking about you, I'm dry as well. I feel like Cape Town's river. The dam. Just dry all the way. But I had a fantastic show today. You'll catch me again on Wednesday. You tomorrow, you're with Jennifer.
Yeah, definitely.
I'll be on Wednesday. And also, if you want to be on our show, if you want to showcase your talents and things like that, it is xcioncapetowntv.org. Or give us a call, 021-448-0448. Is there anything we missed?
There is nothing we've missed. The only thing that we need to do now is to say goodbye with this song.
Bye,
this is Sisi. Enjoy it. Until next time, take care and God bless.
Yes.